At Thrive Teams, we talk a lot about building your list and about getting people to sign up to your email list. But what do you do once those people are on your list? How do you get those people to be engaged, to become fans, to read your content, and to buy your products or services? Well, that's exactly what I'll cover in this video. Hi, my name is Hanne from Thrive Teams, and in this video, I'm gonna talk about 4 different email sequences that I believe everyone should put in place in order to create that engagement, to create that relationship with their list. The first email sequence that you need to create is your welcome sequence. I'm always surprised to see that people do not have a welcome sequence in place. Now, a welcome sequence is the sequence of emails that people will receive right after signing up to your email list. This is typically 5 to 10 emails, and the goal of these emails is threefold. First of all, you want people to get to know you, to get to know your business. Second, you want people to know what you are selling, what you are offering. And third, you want to be sure that people see your best content first, so that they see the most important things when they just sign up to your email list. This means that these emails will be structured around your story, why you created this business, and also what you are offering. So yes, in an email sequence, you can already start selling to people. And then, of course, you also want to make sure that you send them your best content, whether that's a video, a webinar, a blog post, whatever it is. But you want to make sure that something that you are proud of, something that got a lot of engagement with your audience, is the first thing that new people on your list see. Now, the advantage of that is also that even if you're not publishing something new every week, someone who will sign up to your list will still get these emails and will feel this engagement and will feel the activity coming from you, from your website, when they first sign up. So that is the first email sequence I want you to put in place. The second email sequence is one that I see a lot of people feel very reluctant about, but it is a very important email sequence if you actually want to convert your subscribers into buyers. And that is your evergreen sales sequence. Your evergreen sales sequence is exactly that. It is a couple of emails, maybe 5 emails that people will get, where the only goal is to sell them something, is to make sure that they know what you have to offer and that they went through that cycle. Because if you are doing more of a launch strategy where people come on your list and then maybe you don't offer them anything for like 6 months, it might be a missed opportunity, because the moment that someone signs up, they are very interested in your topic. They are trying to solve a problem that you might be able to solve. And at that point, you want to make sure that you give them the opportunity to buy something from you. So I suggest that you put in place an evergreen sales sequence right after your welcome sequence. Like I said, this is about 5 emails that you use to sell people on your offer or your service. In these emails, you want to make sure that you tell them what it is, tell them where they can buy it, what they will get, of course, but also that you address the objections. So make sure to put some emails in there where you show testimonials, where you answer FAQs, so that the people who have objections before buying can get the answer in the email sequence. Now, if you want to take this sequence up a notch, you can use a tool like Thrive Ultimatum to add urgency to this sequence, which means that automatically you can send people a special promotion that it lasts for only a couple of days, so that when somebody signs up to your list, maybe 10 days later, they start getting these sales emails, and then they will see a special offer, and that offer disappears after the sales evergreen sequence stops. So at that point, you can really use the urgency of the promo to get people to buy and to get them to act the moment that they become a subscriber on your list. Now, I also would suggest to repeat this sales sequence 3 months and 6 months later to make sure that people who weren't ready to buy the first time around can buy a little bit later on when they got to know you a bit better. The third sequence that you want to put into place is the feedback sequence. This is something that at Thrive Teams, for example, we do after someone signs up to Thrive University. When you sign up to Thrive University, you will get emails about the different courses, but you also will get a pitch for Thrive Suite. And if after these 10 days of sequence, you didn't buy Thrive Suite, we ask you a question, very simple, that just asks, why didn't you buy? What is holding you back from becoming a customer? Now, this feedback sequence is so important and gives you so much information about what's holding your audience back from buying from you. And you would be surprised at the answers. So do this, put this into place. It's just one email that you ask for personal feedback. Make sure that you answer to these emails. Keep it short and sweet. And then make sure to improve your sales sequence based on the feedback that you got. Now, if you don't have anything to sell yet, still put in place this feedback sequence, because you can still ask for feedback on things like the content that people would like to see from you, or the type of live streams, or whatever it is that you offer to your audience. You want to know what they get stuck with so that you can offer the right solution. And then last but not least, you want to make sure that you have a newsletter sequence. So you want to make sure that you keep in touch with your audience on a regular basis. I believe that the best way to do this is to send at least one email a week, and preferably on the same day every week, so that people get used to seeing your name pop up on the same day every week. If that isn't possible, then maybe commit to once a month. But the truth is that you want to make sure that you stay top of mind whenever somebody might need your product or your service, and that you show up for them over and over and over. And here, consistency really is the key. You would be surprised how many people sign up for a freebie, are not ready to buy, and then 6 months, a year down the line, after having received your free content for a while, they might end up becoming a customer. Just the other day, I was talking to a friend who creates really, really good content, posted on social media, but did not send it to their email list because they were afraid that it would bother people. Now, this is insane to me. I think that it is so important that when you put out content that you believe is interesting for your audience, that you also promote that content. So make sure that when you publish something, that you tell it to your list, that you let your subscribers know about it, because they are the ones who will comment, who will share, and who will amplify the reach of your content. So that's it. These are the four sequences that I believe every business should put in place in order to create that relationship with their list. Now, I want to hear from you. Have you done this already, or did you start putting some in place but don't know what to do next? Let me know in the comments below. And if you are an online entrepreneur, then click that subscribe button and the bell so that you get notified when we publish new content.